don't want your charity, Jason. I told you that.
That's not why I want you to stay. I like having you here. You know, you're easy to be with. You accept me. I even like talking to you or listening, and you know, things were different. Those reasons could be enough.
What do you mean, those reasons? I thought you said that you wanted me to...
You just deserve more than I can ever give.
Yeah, well, shouldn't that be my decision?
I could never put you first. And you deserve that. It wouldn't be fair to you. You know, I have commitments with my work, with Sonny, Carly, and the boys, and I would just end up hurting you more. More than I already have. So I guess it's, you know, it's better for both of us if you go. I just didn't want you to think that there was anything that you did or said, Sam, because I care about you. And it's not your fault, it's my fault.
There's probably a time when I would have blown up at you or tell you exactly what you could do with your pity, but nothing will ever take away how wonderful you have been to me all throughout my pregnancy, and especially when we lost the baby. With that said, I am not gonna pick a fight, and I am just gonna say goodbye.
I need to talk to you about the Playa del Anca casino.
You saw the numbers?
Yeah. Attendance is high, right?
Yeah.
But the profits are down.
Yeah, well, you know, we don't declare all the profits, so someone's getting their cut before posting returns. So what I'm thinking is the obvious person is the manager. He has all the access. But, you know, Enrique's been with you a long time, so I'm thinking that it's someone lower down. I don't
know. What'd you say?
You know what, maybe you should just, you know, fly down there and talk to Enrique yourself.
I'm sorry, I got my head's all over.
I understand, we don't even have to deal with this right now.
No, we do have to settle this because I want you to go down to the playa, right? Talk to Enrique and his staff. Take Sam, I'm sure she, you know, she'll feel a lot better.
Sam left. She moved out.
Jason, you know Sam and I, we've been over for a while, right? And, you know, I've always felt bad about not treating her the way she should have been treated. But if her leaving had anything to do with me, you need to tell me.
I asked her to leave because I care about her. You know what? I don't want her needing me.
Is that such a bad thing?
I don't want her to count on me and then feel betrayed when I disappear to do a job for a couple days, or, you know, Carly calls at 3 a.m. with the next disaster and I have to leave to fix it. Sam deserves better than that.
You ever thought about maybe you need to make an adjustment?
I know that my priorities are all screwed up. And I know that if I'm gonna be with Sam, I have to put her first, but my life is not set up that way, Sonny, and I can't change. I mean, I tried with Courtney, and look how much I hurt her.
And you,
I'm not gonna do that to Sam.
You,
I can't.
You don't think it hurts Sam to leave?
Yeah, it hurt.
All right.
She's gonna be better off without me. Yeah.
Jason, it's Elizabeth. Nicholas was shot trying to escape from the police station. They just brought him in the ER, and Emily's here. She needs you.
Wait, is he okay?
No, Jason, she's terrified. Nicholas is critical. She really needs her family.
I'll be right there.
Well, well, well. Mm-hmm. Well, well, well. So, now that you and Sonny are broken up, could you see yourself and Jason being romantic?
Haven't seen you around a while. Here you are back and dressed to kill. Still drinking whiskey?
Yes, please. Straight up.
Celebrate, you trying to forget tonight?
You think you're a perceptive guy?
I have my moments.
Okay. Look at Sam over there. What is her body language saying?
She's desperate.
She's hurt.
She's ready to lash out.
Again, please. So I'm in the mood to gamble. Where I can find some action.
Looking for action, pussycat. You came to the right place.
Says I can beat your pool again.
How about we play for something other than money?
It's your turn, Carly. Carly?
Sorry.
Oh, hold on. There's the hospital. I have to get this.
Hello, Steven.
Oh. Okay.
Hey, Coleman, here's a little life-saving advice for you. Stay away from Sam, otherwise Jason may get a little upset.
For your information, Jason and I are nothing to each other except ex-roommates.
What are you talking about?
I moved out, Carly. Once again, Jason is all yours. Thank you.
Ooh, okay. Listen, I really don't care about the details. It's none of my business, but whatever happened between you and Jason, there's no reason to throw yourself at Coleman.
Are you pretending to be worried about me? That's kind of cute.
I know what it's like to do something you might regret. You've been trying to chase me away from Jason from the minute he asked me to move in.
You got your wish. I am gone. So is the baby. There's no connection.
Okay, listen, all I'm saying
But the
is
good
that...
news is... This is the good news. I don't have to pretend to get along with you anymore. I can tell you to your face that I think you're a selfish bitch, and I can tell you to leave me the hell alone. And that, my dear, is exactly what I'm doing. Doctor...
Your husband has lost consciousness again.
Let me sit with him. I can convince him to keep fighting.
His vitals are unstable. He's becoming very shocky. If his pressure continues to drop, he'll be beyond our help. I'm sorry.
I go to the chapel. Will you go with me?
Yeah, whatever you need.
Okay. The night I almost died of cancer, I felt myself letting go of this world. And then Nicholas was with me. Not physically. You know, he was in the next room, but his spirit found me. And he convinced me to live. Maybe if I sit here long enough and reach out to him, I can give him the strength to survive.
All we can do is keep praying for him.
Carly.
Hey, Jason, I was just calling you. Sam's in trouble.
What do you mean? What happened?
She's over at Jake's. She's drinking with Coleman.
She moved out. You know, she's got her own life. If she wants to be at Jake's drinking with Coleman, then that's where she wants to be.
Okay, well, Sam's not drinking with Coleman because she thinks he's a great guy. She's drinking with him because her whole life has been turned upside down in the past couple of weeks. She lost her baby, and now apparently you. She doesn't think anything's worth anything anymore, so she figures why not just sink as low as she can get. Look, I shouldn't care. And the truth is, I really don't care about Sam. But I do care about you, and I thought you should know.
I win. Time to pay up. You owe me a dance.
You know you're lucky you lost.
Suppose we can make it. Come on.
Better all the time.